it's the kitty cat of science. He's going to be my assistant today. What was I going to say? What am I doing? I'm doing light bulbs today. And the electric light bulb, invented by Thomas Edison. I'm Mr. Tyrrell, and this is Summer, the science cat, who will be with us till she decides to take off. But anyway, all light bulbs have conductors and insulators and filaments. On this particular light bulb here, we have the conductor, which is metal and connects, goes up through the filament, and comes back down and exits out the bottom of the light bulb. And there's a little insulator right here if you ever look at the bottom of a light bulb. All right? So that's how a light bulb works. And these light bulbs here work the same way. They have a tungsten carbide filament, which gets hot and gives off heat. And there goes our kitty cat of science. When Thomas Edison invented the first light bulb, he used thread that was carbon coated and in a vacuum tube, which is what the light bulb was, and the thread heated up and gave off light. Nowadays they have tungsten in there, and the tungsten carbide heats up. It offers the electricity runs through the filament. The filament is thin enough and offers resistance. The resistance turns the electrical energy into heat energy, and the filament gets white hot, and we see the white light, as we see in this handy dandy little experiment here. And by the way, I do have my parents' permission, and I do have adult supervision. So when we screw in the light bulb is giving off, the filament is getting hot and giving off heat, and this light bulb gets very hot very quickly, so I'm going to unscrew it real quick. This is a fluorescent light bulb. They also come in tubes, and a fluorescent light bulb has argon gas and mercury gas. The electrons, the electricity throws through the electrons in the gas, and as it does it, it bounces, as the electricity flows through, it bounces off the electrons, giving off ultraviolet protons, which is light which we cannot see. We cannot see ultraviolet light. It's not in the visible light spectrum. But the coating of all the fluorescent light bulbs have a phosphorus coating, and when the ultraviolet lights that we can't see gets absorbed by the phosphorus coating, it gives off a white light that we can see. And this is a more efficient light bulb because this light bulb is only making light, it's not making heat, whereas the incandescent lights are making heat. Alrighty, but there's another type of light bulb. And let me get ready here real quick. Hold on. Got it. This is the final type of light bulb, the pickle light. Now, actually, this light here, this light bulb here and the pickle light have a lot in common. This light bulb here uses sodium gas, which heats up and gives off light that we can see. Well, this pickle also has sodium gas, or it has sodium in it left over from the pickling process. And I have my two conductors, one on either side. And I have my electrical source, and I have my insulator. The wood is an insulator, and I am going to turn this off for a second, make my electrical connection. I'm going to put on my safety glasses. Alrighty, my assistant is going to turn off the lights. Alrighty, and what's going to happen now? Is that our, can we shut the door to the laboratory too? There we go. The pickle, the sodium in the pickle is getting excited, and it's bouncing around the pickle, and as it comes down to a more stable light, this is not a fresh pickle. I bought it yesterday. Our pickle could be too cold. There we go. We have the electric pickle.
And the pickle is getting hot. If we open up the door, maybe it'll give it a little bit of light and show what we're doing here. But that is our electric pickle. Looks more like an electrical spark. But hold on for a second. That is turned off. What I'm going to do here is move our two electrodes closer to each other, cut down on the amount of resistance, and in theory, we should get better pickle light. We conducted this experiment last night. Maybe we'll have to use some footage from that. Here we go, and... I'm getting much more light on my side than you're getting on your side. But anyway, the sodium in the light is going, the sodium in the pickle is going through. It's getting excited. When it comes back down to a normal state, it produces a sodium light very similar to the street light. And that is the electric pickle. Voila. My assistant told me that my pickle fell off. I couldn't see that from my particular angle. So let's see if we can really pickle this up here and get this pickle glowing good. Of course, my safety glasses are on because this is a science experiment. And kick it. You can see the smoke coming up from the pickle. Nah, I think our pickle got too cold in the refrigerator. We had a much better experiment last night. Let's see what happens when we take the pickle from last night that we left sitting outside all night. We may have lost all our sodium in this pickle, but we'll give it a shot. Feel the light. Look at that's normal. There is our electric light bulb. Now, oh, this is glowing.
It's the electric pickle.
Well, what is happening is the sodium in the light in the
getting
pickle.
Off light.
Is getting excited, and when it comes back down to a stable condition.